How do you make more money? Specifically, how do you hack into your customer's mind so then that way they would pay for more without thinking? Today, we're going to be making a video on 150 cognitive behaviors that you can use in your restaurant so then that way you can make more money. Hello guys, my name is Wilson, your friend in helping you build a profitable restaurant. Now I get a lot of people emailing me asking me for strategies, tips, and tactics on how you can actually make more money in a restaurant environment. Now if you're running a struggling restaurant, most likely it is because you're not utilizing the strategies that I'm about to share with you today. Now if you're planning to start your own restaurant or sell food online, then these strategies, these tactics, principles that are proven over generations would be super useful for you. And today we're going to be diving into two of them, and I'm going to give you an example of how it works and how you can actually apply it to your restaurant so you can immediately see an effect. Okay, let's dive right in. The gallery of the 150 cognitive behaviors. These are psychological hacks that happen in the back of our minds. So if we understand these items and these behavioral items, we can actually use it to our benefit through designs, through pricing tactic, through our sales strategy. So as we are scrolling through these, let's say for example, we click onto one of these behaviors, zero price effect. So what does it mean? It means that free things tend to have higher value due to risk elimination. And you can click into this, it makes it super easy for you to understand. Zero price effect, three things tends to have a higher value due to risk elimination. Now you can also talk a little bit more about the description. When customers pay for something, they calculate the risk of any dissatisfaction they might get from that product. They have no expectation of free products whatsoever. And that's the reason why you would see a lot of different companies utilizing the zero price effect. For example, offer free shipping. Free shipping can be huge differentiating over your competitors. And as you can see here, it tells you a little bit more about how the application is in the business world. So instead of someone paying $6.99 for shipping, and if you offer free shipping for your business, then it becomes a much, much more attractive offer for your customers. And as you can see here, it also goes into different examples and what category it has and the impact that it has for a business. What you can use and how you can use it, you can implement it today. And I have actually selected two examples that I want to dive into a little bit deeper about how you can utilize this for your restaurant business. First up, it is the charm pricing. People subconsciously prefer pricing that ends in 9 and 99. So this is the charm pricing psychological behavior that we should be aware of. Now, how do you apply it to your restaurant, okay? This description is saying that people tend to think that goods sold for the pricing ending with 9 are much better value than those with rounded prices. This is how our brain process numbers very, very quickly and makes snap judgment about prices and values without any cautious awareness. So when we see something priced at $2.99, we don't see 300, we see 200 bucks. And that's how my wife lives. Every time we go and shop and buy stuff, and literally when she sees 299 and I ask her, hey, is this cheap or not? She's, oh, it's only 200 something dollars. And I go nuts because I'm like, yo man, that's 300 bucks. What are you talking about? So definitely you can use this as a menu item and how you can actually price your items using round numbers over the absolute number, so then that way it can appear as a little bit cheaper. So that's the reason why you see examples of menu items being $14.99 or even like $14.97, and that just makes it seem like that, oh, it's only 14 bucks, not 15 bucks. Let's say if you're ordering an upsize, you know what, $2.99, that seems like it's $2 something, not 3 bucks. So this is reason why we see this so commonly used as a strategy, charm pricing. And then there is something called the motivating uncertainty effect. What is this? This means that people go crazy about the unpredictable rewards. So when people have rewards that are unpredictable, 25% off, freebies, $5, 15, and these are unexpected, they're much more likely to take action. So how does this work? As a research that was done, the task was to drink a large amount of water within 2 minutes. There's two groups that was actually assigned to this. Group A was told that they're going to receive $2 if they complete the task. And group B was told that they're going to receive either $1 or $2 randomly if they complete the task. And guess what? Group A, the completion rate was only 43%, whereas group B, the completion rate was much higher, substantially higher at 70%. So what does that mean? That means that when you have random rewards, it would actually make your customers react differently and much more likely to actually take the action. So you can actually apply this kind of discount for your restaurant as well. So an example would be, there's a restaurant that provides an envelope with a discount voucher at the end of each meal. And in order to use this voucher, there are certain rules to follow. You can use it the next time you visit the restaurant. You can't open the envelope with the voucher. The waiter opens it on your next visit. You never know what kind of discount you're gonna get, and which is the reason why you're much more likely to take the action. The rewards vary from getting nothing to an extra dessert, side dish, 20% off, and a free meal. And once again, you can utilize motivating uncertainty effect in your restaurant. And these are psychological behaviors that are happening in the back of your mind without you thinking. So just imagine you having this slight edge over all your competitors. You implementing these strategies that I'm sharing on your customers, it doesn't seem like a sleazy tactic. However, these are psychological proven methods. Stack a few of these methods and strategies in your restaurant, and for sure, you're gonna be able to make a ton more money. So as you can see here, there's more than 150 cognitive behaviors created by my friend Michal from Brainiac. And so if you guys wanna get access to this, we are actually having a sale for him. Go onto the site down below, and you're gonna be able to see that you can get access to this for right here, Brainiac. You can actually click on this link, Brainiac, and you're gonna be able to get access to all 150 cognitive behaviors. Definitely check them out. Super, super effective. This is something that, you know, it doesn't only apply to restaurants, but also in any areas of business. I completely fell in love with it after seeing it because it is so, so valuable. And it's so easy to understand, making these really complex psychological behaviors super easy to understand. Definitely go check them out, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Something much more tactical for you to use. Definitely go check them out in the link below. I'll see you guys in next week's video.